guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm so glad you stopped by today because today we are starting back up on our painting series on ARK Survival Evolved. So we're going to be starting the second painting in the series. Anyways, let's get started. Okay guys, so for today I'm going to be painting the Frost Titan from Extinction. I knew when I was going to do some ARK paintings that I needed to do one of the Titans, so I picked one of my favorites, which was the Frost one. I just ended up really liking the design of this one, and I thought it was really nice and aesthetically pleasing. Now honestly, I like the design of most of the Titans. I do have a few problems with some of them. I don't really care for the Forest Titan. I think it could have came off a lot better. I don't know, maybe I just wanted it to look a little bit more realistic and more Groot-like, but I feel like there's just a little bit off with the textures on it. Now, on the other hand, the Desert Titan I really like, and it's honestly my second favorite, mainly because it reminds me of a character from an old book that I used to read. I can't even remember the title of it, but it's basically about, like, these stingray-type aliens that live in space, and a human is turned into one so that they can coexist and learn their ways. It's so strange, and it's probably not even a kid's book, but I really enjoyed it, and this is how I kind of pictured those creatures from the book to look like. But yeah, if any of you guys have read this book, you kind of understand what I'm talking about, but most of you have no clue what I'm talking about, and unless you've read the book, you probably will never be able to find the book. But yeah, back to the Frost Titan. I think the main reason I really like it is it didn't come off as, like, super snow-themed or anything like that. You could change it up a little bit and tell me it's a different element completely, and I would believe you. It doesn't just scream snow. It's really more versatile, and I really like that about it. Honestly, the only thing on this that screams Frost Titan is the fact that it's a little bit furry and it has this ice horn right in the middle of its face. If you guys are wondering, since I said in the last video that I didn't have the game, I do have it now and have been able to play a little bit. I don't have a lot of free time, but I have been making time for it at night and I've really enjoyed it. Now, one thing that I kind of like, kind of hate, is the way the map is set up. I like the idea of the city in the middle and each corner of the map being a different element in different area, but also I kind of hate it at the same time because it makes everything really hard to get. So it kind of forces a lot of people to play right in the middle and build their base in the city, which could be a good thing for like PvE, but for PvP it does not work out at all. Now, one thing I wish they kind of did, since they did break up the map into, like, the four corners, is I kind of wish they based the Titans off of, what is it called? I'm not 100% sure. I think it's either Japanese or Chinese, but there's a mythology where each direction of the compass has a guardian for that direction. I believe it's, like, a tiger, a dragon, a phoenix, and then a two-headed turtle. I think the Titans would have looked really interesting if they based them off of those elements. But that's just me, and I really like how things have themes and kind of go along with old mythology and stuff like that, and I think it would have been cool to have a little bit more of that in the game. Now, one thing you'll probably notice in these time-lapse videos, which I've tried to get rid of, but it's nearly impossible, is the lighting change. Now, it's mainly because right now we're going through winter, so it's constantly dropping from super cloudy to really bright to rainy to cold to warm. The weather has no idea what it's doing, and it's changing the lighting super drastically throughout the day. Plus, some of the painting I had to do at night because I just didn't have time to do it any other time of the day. So again, the lighting constantly changes and it just looks weird, and I've done my best to make it look as cohesive as possible. But honestly, the next big investment I need to do is I need to get a ring light so I can control this and make it look a lot more professional. So I really hope the lighting changing doesn't bug you too much. I know somewhere in here, like, a glare of light was slowly creeping in on my painting, and I actually had to stop because it landed on my painting and you couldn't see what I was doing. So I had to actually stop recording and wait for the time to change where this light had passed my little painting area. But yeah, you'll see this somewhere in the time lapse of my video. I'm not quite sure when, but you just start seeing that little line slowly coming closer and closer to the painting. And I really couldn't edit it out because what I was doing at that time was important, and I don't want to skip steps. I want to show the whole painting. Plus, I thought it looked a little funny in the sped up video because you can just see it go really, really quickly towards the thing and then it just disappears. Now, if you guys are curious, I am going to be doing one of the creatures from ARK Extinction as an art doll. I've already got it picked out, and I've got all the fabric ordered and stuff like that, and I just need to start putting it together. And hopefully we can get it out kind of around the end of this series. Now, just because I already have the creature picked out that I want to work on, doesn't mean I can't do more of them. So if you guys have any other suggestions on which creatures from ARK, or anything honestly at all that you want to see made, leave them down below and we'll see what we can do. I know one other creature that would be kind of cool would be the snow owl. I haven't picked that one for the creature that I wanted to do because I wanted to challenge myself, and I thought the snow owl would have been just a little too easy. Because I've done bird creatures before and I wanted to try something with a little bit different anatomy. But maybe if this series does really well, maybe we can do all three of the titans or something, or maybe the boss titan or something. I don't know. We'll see what happens. But anyways, guys, we are getting close to the end of this video, so we should probably get back to the topic of this painting. Now, one thing about this painting that was a lot of fun was trying to do the horn, because I've never painted ice before, and it was really interesting messing around with the colors to create where it has that effect where the ice looks thicker in one spot and thinner and more translucent in another, and it was just a lot of fun. Now, I did have some trouble with this painting, and it was mainly around the eyes, mainly because the eye is sunken in, so there's a lot of shadowing, but there's also a glow to the eye, so I didn't want the glow to overwhelm the shadow and just kind of blur out the details around the eye, but I also didn't want the glow to go away. I wanted to have both, and I think I found a good even point between the two, but it was quite difficult to get both of those effects going at the same time. One thing that was quite interesting was trying to figure out what to do with the background. I couldn't have something super detailed because the face has all that detail and I didn't want to pull away from it, but I also didn't want it to be like super plain, like just leaving it white or something. With the owl, it was a little bit different because of the way I drew him. You had a lot of the background available, so I had to throw something back there. So I put one of the obelisks and just some of the mountains and added a lot of like coloring effect. But with this, there's so little of it available. So putting something like trees or something in the background or snow, you wouldn't really have enough of it to work with to be able to tell what it is. So I decided to go with just simple brush strokes and just some colors to help contrast the face of the creature. In the long run, I really like how this came out. I mean, as an artist, you always want to make it look more and more and more realistic, but with this one, I tried to pull back and have it a bit more painty so it could be a bit more fun, and I didn't want to have it like, I don't know, if I tried to go super realistic, I think I would have messed it up, and leaving all the paintbrush strokes in and stuff, I think makes it look really cool. Okay guys, and that's how I painted the Frost Titan from ARK Extinction. I had so much fun with this and I can't wait to start on the final painting. Anyways guys, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, do all that fun stuff, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!